Hello everyone, quick editor's note here. Had to redo this video due to a copyright strike and YouTube's system to fix said copyright strike, making the audio on the original video poo-poo levels of quality. So I thought I'd just remake it. Hope you enjoy. Welcome Platinum Hunters to Platinum Trophy Review, or PTR for short. Here at PTR, I go over a game that I have recently platinumed and give you tips and tricks to help you get those shiny digital trophies, as well as to inform you on what to expect when attempting said game. So sit down, shut up, and open your textbooks to page 69, and let's start the school year unlocking those trophies. We've got a lot to go through in this week's game, Bully. But before we begin, make sure that you're subscribed to the channel for more gaming related content. Hit that like button and drop a comment on what your favorite Rockstar game is. Also, don't forget to follow me on Twitter if you don't want me to give you a wedgie. So, what is Bully? Well, Bully is an action-adventure video game developed by Rockstar Vancouver and published by Rockstar Games. It was released on the 17th October 2006 for the PlayStation 2. Bully was re-released for the PlayStation 4, available via the PlayStation Network on the 22nd of March 2016. The game is played from a third-person perspective and is set in the fictional town of Bullworth. The single-player story follows juvenile delinquent student James Jimmy Hopkins, who is involuntarily enrolled in Bullworth Academy for a year, and his efforts to rise to the ranks of the school system in order to put a stop to bullying. Bully consists of 38 trophies, which are 4 gold, 10 silver, 23 bronze, and of course, 1 platinum trophy. Make no mistake going into this, that almost all of Bully's trophies are a grind. So we're going to do a play-by-play in order you should strive to unlock said trophies. Bully has 6 chapters, the first 5 being story-related and the 6th being post-game, where we can clean up any trophies outstanding. The first 3 trophies you should aim to unlock are Green Thumb, which is to pick 50 flowers, and Casanova, which is to kiss 25 girls. These 2 trophies go hand in hand, as at first, to be able to kiss a girl, you will need to gift them flowers. You can hold 10 flowers at a time, and the best place to pick them is in front of the girls' dorm, which is opposite the boys' dorm. Now, the reason you want to get Green Thumbs out of the way first is because as you pass your English classes, you gain the ability to bypass gifting flowers and go straight to kissing, making this trophy more difficult than it should be. However, if like me, this has happened to you, you can gift flowers to certain boys at school. There is a blonde boy with a short sleeve shirt who you can gift the flowers to. Segueing into school classes, there are 6 subjects that you have to complete. There are 2 classes every day, one at 9 a.m. and the other one at 1 p.m. English, art, chemistry, gym, photography, and shop. Each subject consists of 5 classes that you need to complete to unlock the gold trophy, Boy Genius. Now, in general, most of these classes shouldn't be a problem. Nonetheless, watch out for English and shop, as they will give you the most problems. Let me explain. For English, in each class you'll be given several letters and you'll have to create words with said letters to be able to pass a class. This is more troublesome as it seems, as you only have 3 minutes to think up 15 or more words. In the description, I will leave the link to Bully's trophy guide, and at the end you'll find a useful cheat sheet for the words you can use in each class. Shop brings its own headaches, as though it is just press a certain button and rotate a joystick in a certain direction to be able to complete. The direction for when it comes to rotating the joystick is extremely sensitive. If you fail the button output 3 times, you will fail the class, and you will have to wait a whole in-game week to be able to retry it. So my recommendation is the following. First of all, before starting any class, save the game, because if you fail, just reload the save point and you can try again. That way you don't have to wait a whole week, air quotations, with shop. Watch videos of the buttons needed to pass the class and write them down. When it comes to rotating the joystick either way, have the joystick pressed to either side before the direction indicator comes on screen, as this way you will not fail. Passing classes comes with its benefits, like more combos for fighting, making it easier to pick up the ladies, and once all classes are complete, the prefix will leave you alone during class hours and not chase you down. The after hours can be achieved fairly early as well. It requires you to stay 5 hours outside after curfew, which is 11 p.m. Now Jimmy can only stay up until 2 in the morning, where he will then pass out. You will wake up in the same place you fainted, but only 3 hours will have counted. Repeat the next evening and the trophy will unlock. The best place to do this is in the bin in front of the boys' dormitory. Smell you later is to hit 50 people with stink bombs, and watch your step is to trip up 25 people with marvels. The best place to do this will be in the boys' dorm. Pull the fire alarm, and as the boys make their way to the exit, drop the marbles on the floor or throw the stink bombs. But be prepared to book it, as you will start a fight. Speaking of fights, you will need to knock out 200 people for down for the count. This should unlock naturally through your playthrough. Dual Nebula is to get 3 high scores in 3 arcade games in Bully: Consumo, Nutshots, and Monkey Fling. All 3 games can be found in the souvenir tent at the carnival. They are not too hard. It took me about 3 times in each to get the high scores. Before going in, make sure you know what the high score is, so that once you surpass it, you can die and end the game. In Consumo, take your time and avoid the blowfish at all cost. Nutshots just fly up and down, constantly shooting, and in Monkey Fling, you have limited ammo. You get more when you eat a banana. Make sure that you always have bananas falling, as they fall extremely slow. Hearing me say all this makes zero sense, I know, but when you play these games, you will get what I'm saying. Since you're at the carnival, look into getting Glass Dismissed, which is to shoot 300 bottles at the shooting gallery. Now here you have a wooden fence where stars, cowboys, a woman, and the green bottles will pop up above. Focus only on the bottles and on half the fence. If you start scanning the whole fence, you're going to miss a ton of bottles, and this is going to take longer than it should. So only focus on half the fence, in my case, the left side, and shoot the bottles that you can. You can get about 30 to 35 per game, so grind it out now or do it gradually. Another trophy associated with the carnival is Speed Freak, where you have to win 5 go-kart races. They are not too hard. Nevertheless, I found the AI in these races extremely aggressive, where they straight up just ram you, so the quicker you get in pole position, the better. After completing all 5 go-kart races, you will unlock the street race version. There are 3 in total, and once all 3 are completed, you unlock pole position. However, you will have to wait until chapter 5, as the 3rd race is in the part of town that only unlocks in said chapter. Moving on to bullshitty, is that a word? Grindy trophies. Smart Mouth, taunt 100 times. Skidmark, give 50 wedges, you can only wedgie boys. Kicking the ball, kick a ball 100 times. There are 2 in front of the boys' dorm, one on either side as you come out. So Delicious, buy 100 sodas. Green Thumb, mow the lawn 10 times. In chapter 2, when the town unlocks, look for the mowing job in the park. Excellent, egg 25 cars. Easiest way to do this is to stand in front of a car, press up on the D-pad to aim, and throw away. Get ready to run though. The Wheel Deal, perform 200 wheelies on a bike. While riding, press down on the left joystick. The Expert Bicycle Thief. You need to steal 20 bikes. You have to steal from people riding a bike for this to unlock. Mama's Boy. Complete the T errands. These are random errands that NPCs will ask you to do, so be on the lookout for a blue cross on your minimap. Rich Kid Blues have $1,000 in pocket change on you. If you watch your pennies, you should unlock this trophy naturally. However, the trophy Sharp Dressed Man requires you to buy 250 clothing items. For this, there is a money cheat code that gives you $100 each time inputted. Save the hassle and use this when it comes to buying clothes, as you will need over $2,500 to achieve this. Also, there are only 3 clothing shops, one at the school and 2 in town. Buying all clothes from all 3 will not be enough. The game does not tell you that you can buy the rest from a barbershop. But not any barbershop, the one that can be found in the greaser part of town called The Final Cut. Special note here, there is a cheat code to unlock all clothing items. Do not use this, as doing so will void the trophy. Any other cheat code will not void trophies. Collectibles. Now, the only collectible trophy is Kleptomania, where you have to acquire all room trophies. Now, 90% of these are obtained by doing missions in-game and passing classes. There are only 7 you need to look out for. 3 of them are to destroy pumpkins, tombstones, and gnomes. Now, the first 2 become available during Halloween, but seeing as you are on limited time for that night, I would ignore them and do the missions assigned. Now obviously the next day the pumpkins and tombstones cannot be found anywhere on the grounds. Do not fret. Towards the end of chapter 1, you will make your way into the school basement and will find all pumpkins stored there. Smash away and move on. The tombstones will only become available in chapter 5. They are stored in a factory, in this part of town. You will access this factory twice while playing the story missions. They are to the left as you walk in. Gnomes are a bit more complicated as they can be found everywhere. So wait until chapter 5 because like I said, by then you will have access to everywhere and get a guide open to find them. The last four are to complete level 4 of the paper route, complete all BMX races, and to purchase the car and rock poster from the carnival souvenir shop. They cost 10 tickets each. The last mission is found in chapter 6, Smash It Up, which comes available at 7 p.m. Once finished, go to your room for the trophy to pop, obviously depending if you've done everything else first. Okay, on to the final stretch of this game. You will need to travel a grand total of 100,000 meters on foot, bike, and 50,000 on skateboard for their respective trophies to pop. Skateboarding has a little bit of cheese as you can hitch a ride on the back of a car by pressing triangle. And for the final trophy, Problem Child, which is to amass a total of 106,000 trouble points in-game. Now, by the end of the game, you could be in around 70 to 100,000 trouble points. All this can be seen in the stats part of the menu in the pause screen, by the way. Now, not to drag this out any more than it needs to be, save this for post-game. Go into town and punch an adult or police officer. Your trouble meter will go straight to the red and you will get 300 to 350 points for this. Here comes the bullshit part. Once your meter is full, you have to wait for it to go down before you can punch another person. This can take anywhere up to a minute to go down. But I found a decent and quick way to farm this. Like I said, go into town and punch an adult. Police will spawn and take you to jail. Now here's the best part. There is no negative to going to jail. You don't lose any money or time in a day, and when you come out, your meter is at zero. So repeat the process. As you leave jail, punch an adult and wait for the long arm of the law to take you away. It took me about an hour to farm this, so this might vary. What I can suggest to make this final grind less hellish is that during your playthrough, when traveling through town on missions, just punch a random adult and be on your merry way, as you can start missions even when half the town is gunning for your head. After all this hellish grind is complete, you should be the proud owner of an ultra rare 3.3% platinum trophy. So is Bully's Platinum worth the grinding and time? Well, as we all know, Rockstar are notorious when it comes to their trophy list. I love GTA 5 and Red Dead Redemption 2, but there is no way on God's green earth that I am attempting to get those platinums for those games. Bully, however, happens to be more manageable, even though its trophies are grindy. This one will come down to preference, as you will really need to want it to strive for this platinum. The game in itself is not hard and is a nice reminder of the good old PS2 days. Though when playing on my PS5, the game started lagging every time I went to the carnival area, but nothing major. Also, the camera can give you a bit of a headache if you play for too long. So after all the wedgies and knocked out teeth, Bully's Platinum is getting expelled from school, 5 out of 10. As stated before, that the trophy list might put some people off. Thanks Platinum Hunters for watching, I hope you found this video helpful. Please drop a comment, hit the like button, and sub to the channel, because that is what all the cool kids are doing. Now go to the principal's office.